We have officially entered a new era, not just where there are streaming services, but streaming services that are brand specific. DC is the first to market, but Disney, as soon as that Fox acquisition is approved, and it looks like Comcast just dropped out this morning, so it looks like that's gonna go through with the official vote on July 27th, I'm sure that within a matter of days, if not, you know, weeks maybe, but I think it's gonna be extremely soon, you're gonna get some kind of announcement about the Disney, not only about the Disney streaming service, but that it's probably gonna be a rebranded Hulu, because of course, as part of that deal, Disney gets the controlling interest. And I'm glad to see DC doing this. I wish that the quality was a little higher. Although I have to say, that's my opinion. I was surprised that some of you really like this because I think it looks really bad. But there are elements that, you know, as a comic book fan, I mean, this is the life of a comic book fan. Whenever we see our stuff adapted to a different medium, there's always little bits and pieces that you're like, oh, this looks stupid, but I'm curious about that. Or that was kind of cool. And so that's how they hook you. Although for all of you who make fun of Gotham, you didn't see how well off you were, right? I mean, look how cheap a show that there can be. This actually does remind me of the Marvel Netflix shows, not where they started out, but where they are right now. It's just so damn cheap. Although some of you, one of you in particular pointed out that this has had a similarity to Riverdale, which reimagined Archie and the gang as not like angst-ridden and in a very dark and dangerous sexual and mysterious situations, right? It's kind of what the whole Archie brand has been doing, and it's been very successful for them. They started out doing it with the comics, now they moved it into television, and I think the Sabrina show on Netflix, speaking of streaming, actually is looking pretty darn good. But I think that where Riverdale and Sabrina succeed and Titans fails is that they're higher budget, and I think that the writing is better. It seems better. I mean, obviously, this is just the trailer. I think the casting is better. And also, they're very clever, not only in the storylines, but also how they twisted the characters. I think this, to me, seems cheap, not only in how much they spent on it, but cheap in the choices that they made. They're easy, they're lazy. You know, like F Batman, it's like, come on, that's like the laziest writing possible. You can just see the writing room being like, oh, and then he says F Batman, and you realize this is a new Robin. Although as many of you are saying, yeah, it's Jason Todd. And I agree, it is Jason Todd. And there are a lot of different Robins for a reason. They all have their fan bases, and you better not mix them up. All right, so let's get started. Let's get into this. Because again, as I said, there are some cool things in here that, you know, hook you. So when I reacted to this, I was very surprised to see this mature rating warning. Because, you know, you don't see that in front of the CW shows, right? Although this seems to have, maybe it's going to have more sex and more violence, right? But I think also because they feel, it looks a little like the CW shows, and this is a comic book character. It's got Bretton Thwaites in it, right? Maybe he's got some underage fans. I think that this is just DC covering their butt, being like, the legal department was like, please put, also, I think it was half the legal department, and then half, like, the PR people being like, it's going to make us look pretty cool. Although, if you put a warning like this on your show, you better deliver. Like, but like in a cool way, not in a trying too hard way. All right. So we start out with this like cheap circus, but they're like, no, it's not cheap. It's Dream Circus, which also is low budget, thank goodness. Now here's Raven, who I feel is going to be my least favorite character in the show. I really hate her casting. I think she's not a good actress. And I think it's a huge missed opportunity to cast an actress of color. Now, I know they also race-bended Starfire, but maybe this should have been the character they race-bended. And I would have gone with a Middle Eastern or maybe an Indian actress to try to play into the mythology of those countries and the demon. And, you know, I think they have some cool demons. And I think you could have done some really cool visuals, you know, with her father Trigon coming from Azeroth, this demonic dimension. For those of you who are Marvel fans, she's a little like Ileana Rasputin, you know, Colossus's little sister magic. It's kind of that similar situation. So I would, you know, I think that this like, you know, fresh off the farm actress, you know, that's the look that she has. I just, you know, she's constantly fighting against herself to play this role accurately. I just really don't like it. And also, I don't like the cheapness of this setup. They're like, oh, Flying Graysons. And I'm like, don't you try and bring me in with the mythology like that. You got to make more of an effort. You can't just plaster Flying Graysons on the wall. You didn't even commission art for a poster. You just literally wrote it on there. You didn't even write it on there. You put it on a digital thing that you can erase and change. And you didn't even have, there's no audience, right? I mean, we've seen this scene a lot, the death of the Flying Graysons, and just like we've seen the death of the Waynes. We'll talk about how good Bretton Thwaites looks when we get more to him. That's kind of a good shot. I think they used that shot like a couple of times, but I guess we'll stop here. I think he looks great. He looks a lot like Dick Grayson to me. You know, there's been a lot of discussion with the potential movie, although I told you from what I heard that movie, it's dead. It's never going to happen. It's not officially canceled, but no one's paying attention to it. It's the carcass in the development room. But a lot of people wanted to see someone like a Romani actor, you know, from Romania, you know, gypsies, all that stuff, cast in the role of Dick Grayson, you know, because he comes from circus folk, et cetera, et cetera. They wanted that representation. I think it's interesting to get down to representation at that level in a country way, but I can see it, you know, especially how Romani people have been portrayed, you know, way back to like the Hunchback of Notre Dame, right? So I think it's a nice opportunity. And even though Bretton Thwaites is from Australia, I see that element to him. I think he represents well. Now, in the comics, he went to work for the Bluehaven Police Department. He and Batman had a falling out. He's like, I gotta be my own man. But this was not during the Titan stuff. But later on, he went to Bluehaven and he became a police detective, as you see here. But I don't like it because even though it's comics faithful, so much of the Marvel Netflix shows take place in a police station. And it reminds me too much. It's too much like what Marvel Netflix is doing. And also, I can't stand the poor lighting. They're like, how do we hide this cheap-ass set and cheap-ass visual effects? And they're like, I know. Turn down the lights. Like Titans doesn't like to get down to action with the lights on. And that's like, no, turn on the lights, damn it. All right, I paid $75 for this. So I have a problem with that. Let's see here. So I like the look on his face. He's like another crazy person. So there's his parents. There's the rope snap and him screaming. I mean, I've seen it so often that I feel if you're gonna do this, I mean, we've seen, again, this is something that's been done so many times in so many different mediums. Like, if you're gonna do it, you gotta really plus it, you know? I mean, and also, this is a dream sequence. Come on, production department. You know, prove yourself. And they're like, well, you didn't give us enough money. I'd be like, you're supposed to be able to, if you're a professional, you're supposed to be able to overcome that. What about all those stories about I only had $10 and look what I did? So, you know, if I were the producer, I blame the the production department. I'd be like, they're just not creative enough over there. But yeah, so I think that I would have preferred this to be a little more interesting. So this also, the old shirtless in the apartment routine, Daredevil, he has, you know, he copyrighted that, right? Charlie Cox, Bretton Thwaites is like, no, me too. And you're like, come on, buddy, you know? And then he's like, oh, I hate my, I'm still going to use my Robin rings. I always wonder with these, I'm like, could they really, do they have the dynamics to really fly through the air? But I guess if a bat symbol can too, why not, right? Batman's like, you're not too good for my equipment, right? Why don't you go cast some Fs? All right, but let's talk about this, because this is the sequence. I like this actually a little bit. I've got pluses and minuses with this action sequence. So right here, they look up, and I like the way, hold on. They're like, because, you know, obviously they're like, are there any vigilantes around? I like the way the figure goes across the rooftop. I think that's really cool. And that you can barely see it. And it looks believable, too, which is why I kind of geek out about it. I'm like, oh, yeah, that's what it would look like if I was standing down below and I looked up and Batman or Robin or who knows. Rooftops are awfully crowded these days, right? But that's totally what it would look like. So they're like, the same shot. So I like when he lands. I think that's pretty cool, the way the cape goes up. But the yellow underneath is a nice touch, right? He's probably so angry because he's so colorfully dressed, though. It's like, change your costume, change your life, right? So he lands, and I think that looks pretty cool. I liked that, actually. Although domino masks, by the way, in real life, just look so ridiculous. He's not like, hey, Dick, how you doing? I guess I'll see you. You know, aren't you that police officer, you know, police detective? It's just so obviously him. So they're all like, oh, where's Batman? All right, so that really makes Robin angry. He's like, I'm my own vigilante, damn it. And so look, he uses his grappling hook and he shoots that guy like in like the back. And so that means like it hooked into his flesh and he pulls him backwards. Like, I agree with you guys. This is total Jason Todd. Dick Grayson would never do these things. I don't care how upset he got. Like, if Dick Grayson got upset, I don't even think he'd swear. Like, forget saying F Batman. I don't think he'd swear at all. Now, I'm sure one of you will find a comic book panel maybe where some misguided writer had Dick Grayson swear. But for the most part, when you look at the Batman Bible for the characters, he doesn't swear. Dick Grayson doesn't swear. So he goes full Jason Todd, pulls this guy in, is able to dodge a bullet, stabs someone in the neck, right? And then uses his gun. And again, bad people don't use guns, right? I mean, I know that in Batman v Superman, some people had some issue with Batman killing, but I always felt like Batman, like, he killed by default. He, like, didn't save. He was like, you know, usually they land in the water or on an awning, right, if it's an animated show. And here, they died, you know, and Batman's like, that's what you get for choosing a life of crime. And he also, I guess he too was depressed, right? Boy, when vigilantes get depressed, everyone else suffers. Or I guess the criminal element does. But just to see him using a gun like that and shooting people, it's just out of character. And he steps on, I don't know if it broke that guy's neck or not, or he just did it to insult him, you know, like stepped on his face. But I mean, I don't know. That just seems very childish and petty. And then he's like, F Batman. And you can see he's got dirt and grime on his face, you know. And he's like, well, what are you still wearing, Bat? I guess that's why he'll change to the Nightwing costume during the course of the show. But as I said in my trailer reaction, and as some of you agreed with me down below in the comments section, it's like, and one of you was very articulate about it and said, you know, yeah, Batman took you in, gave you a cool mansion and a home, so you didn't have to go into foster care after your parents were killed. He gave you an amazing life as a vigilante with all these amazing gadgets and financial support. But yeah, F him. That was a great comment. That's exactly how I feel. It's like really not cool. I mean, I hate it when people get upset with Batman. I think Batman, he's got a lot of problems, and I think that people just, you know, there's a famous Marilyn Monroe quote, and she said, people want an awful lot for very little. Batman can relate to that. Okay. So this fall. All right, so starting in 2018, that's great. So there's some really non-convincing Raven stuff. So you can see her eye. I think maybe when she has visions, maybe her eyes disappear like that. That's, you know, you can do that with like practical effects and stuff. So that's pretty good. Tricks for demonic kids, right? So you can see she's got some demonic possession stuff going on there. People love like exorcist stories. So I think putting that element in there does, I can see why they would think that, but I don't think it's particularly well executed. And then you can see she kind of like move into like a shadow. Oh my God. It's like so much of this is just crazy editing techniques. Instead of like actual genuine effects. And then she can push this dude into a wall, right? And he's like, whoa, well, all right, fine. You can have the last of the cereal. So there's Beast Boy. I like the cool purple lighting on his arm there. He does turn green. I think this is a thing where like they only look more like their comic book counterparts when they're using their powers to save money. So he turns green, but as you can see, doesn't turn into an animal. One of you had a funny idea, and they were like, are they going to cut away, and then like a green cat just comes into frame, right? He always turns into like really easily attainable animals, right? That's, you know, that's like the, you know, production winking at you. I mean, I don't know. I think I'm Ryan Potter. I hope he's happy. He really wanted to be a comic book character, and I keep thinking he got the short end of the stick. It's, you know, careful what you wish for and all that. Now, as for Anna Diop, now I said she was the best character, and I do think her powers make this a better situation. And some of you were like, oh, Grace, you did a 180. And it's like, she still is clearly a streetwalker. She's clearly a prostitute. I guess when she landed on our planet, that's what she decided to do. She was enslaved in her history in the comics, remember, on another planet. Maybe she's still enslaved and been forced into being a sex worker. You know, I think that could be an interesting twist. Maybe. I think it's a little obvious. You know, I think whenever someone wants to make a female character gritty, for some reason, they're like, make her a prostitute. And you're like, that's like such 1970s thinking of what's a gritty woman. And also, like, as I said, I think the changing Starfire's innocent celebration of her sexuality into being a sex worker, I think, you know, really flies in the face of the character. And we'll see if this version of the character flies. But I think that the VFX do make her look cooler, and she's the most visually interesting character on the show. I fully believe that. But based on where she's standing and everything, and where they find her in the street, it sounds to me like a typical, like, oh, well, let's harass this prostitute. And she's like, enough's enough already. So you can see like the way the power kind of comes together, like her fingers tips start to light up with fire. That's pretty neat. And she doesn't do the green blast, to many of you's disappointment. She just exudes fire. So I guess the name is Starfire, right? And it seems like it comes from inside, because not only does her hair light up, I thought maybe her forehead at first was just lighting up with like a raven-like dot, but instead I think it's all of her skin underneath, and that's what creates the orange skin effect that only shows up when she uses her powers now. And her eyes do light up green, which I appreciate. I'm with many of you. In the display for this, they should have included them using their powers in the still photos, especially, I guess, because the trailer, just drop the trailer a little bit earlier before you open the doors to the event, is what I would think. But anyway, I think that looks like not bad, right? I mean, again, it's the most visually interesting. I mean, I can see myself watching the show and being like, yeah, I'll just wait for Starfire to light up. At least that's cool to look at. And Anna D up seems, you know, in a lot of turmoil there. As they say, time for inner demons. Oh! it's so like Nickelodeon almost. All right, let's see here. Like, they're trying to be a dark, gritty adult show, but yet it doesn't seem like it's written by adults. It seems like a tween idea of what it means to be an adult. So silly. So here's Dove. That's actually, I think, the best costume that we've seen so far. I don't know why in such a dark, gritty show, someone would be like, I'm gonna paste a giant cutout paper dove to my pelvis, right? You'd be like, what's this costume? What are you thinking here? I mean, I know it's comics accurate, but I've never liked the costume even in the comics, quite frankly. Oh, but look, those fabric wings that look so clearly like fabrics, well, when you add a little bit of CGI, they're suddenly razor blades. So it cuts that person's leg. There's Hawk showing up. Now here we have some villains. What do you know? They're also, angsty, Riverdale type characters. I'm guessing they're going to be like members of the Brother Blood cult, because I think a cult would totally fit in. And also, you know, having to some Raven front and center so much, and Brother Blood being a classic Titans villain, you know, I can maybe see that being the choice here based on what we're seeing here. Maybe that is Brother Blood, actually, come to think of it. Look, he's got a lot of blood all over his mouth, and Brother Blood, you know, is kind of vampiric, you know, consumes blood. And there you can see Hawk being taken down by two of maybe Brother Blood's minions. There's some kind of like a whip or something around his neck, and then a baseball bat to the head. Harley's like, that's my move. A lot of baseball bats in the DC universe. So there's some more Raven's crazy. Let's see, like, I hear think here what's happening. It's so hard to see what's happening so often. It's so cheap. Come on. All right, but anyway, I think here she maybe, like, some version of her gets trapped in the mirror. Like, so, by the way, it's so Enchantress, and Enchantress was so amazingly done VFX-wise. Like, it's kind of not cool to be like, why can't I have something that cool? And you're, I mean, you know why. They can't afford it, but that's a great shot of Starfire. That's really cool, at least. And now that her skin looks almost pink there. She looks, you know, like she's really suffering, you know? And I don't know, like a sex worker who's like victimized. I don't know. It's very interesting. I don't even want to get into the whole sex worker conversation. Some people on, like one or two people on Twitter were like, sex workers are awesome. Don't say anything bad about being a sex worker. And it's like, you know about sex trafficking? And, you know, I can't imagine anybody would argue that being a prostitute is an empowering profession. But I don't want to get into that kind of conversation here. But I think that's a cool shot. That's the cool, in my opinion, that's the coolest shot in the trailer. It's just visually arresting. And, you know, so at least it's got that going for it, even though it has so many other problems. So I don't know what's happening here. At first, I thought maybe she stopped the bullet with her hand, but how would she think she obviously failed? And then I was like, is she making his face explode by touching it? And I looked up Dove's powers. So I was like, I don't remember that from the comics. And she does not apparently have she can make things explode by touch. So I don't know what's going on there. And then someone got thrown into a roof. At first, I thought that was like a cape or something. I was like, what's going on here? Is that like wings? I was like, no, it's just a roof for like someone's pigeon coop on the roof. There's Beast Boy. Not as cool. Like, his skin doesn't even look green there. And they can't both have light up green eyes, him and Starfire. That's crazy. I guess they're like, we already did the VFX package for Starfire. Let's just layer it over Beast Boy, Ryan Potter. So let's see here. More stuff happening in the pitch black. Oh, yeah. And so Raven's like, my mother told me that there's no such thing as monsters. And I'm like, wow, I can't believe she looked you in the eye and lied to you like that, because your dad's a monster. Or her mother's like really naive, right? Like Rosemary's Baby. But in this case, Rosemary has no idea what happened. She's like, that was a fun party. Okay. So let's see. And then Dick Grayson's like, oh yeah, I know about monsters too. And I'm like, are you kidding me? I hope you're not referring to Batman with that comment. I am totally team Batman. So I'm gonna have a real problem with this version of Dick Grayson if he's gonna be trash talking Batman all the time. And then you can see there she's doing her best Enchantress impression. Also Elsa, you know, doesn't that look like Elsa? Is there someone on the other door being like, do you want to build an Ashman, you know, or Lava Man? But I think that, I don't know. I just think that actress is just so poorly cast as Raven. It's driving me insane. It's just so, it's not Raven, right? And then here's what's really weird. They're like, here's the new logo. And I'm like, what were you pushing that other logo for so long then, if this is what the logo is? And by the way, the first logo is cooler, so I don't understand why you have this logo instead. I don't know why they would make more CW shows. I mean, wouldn't you want the DC streaming service to have its own signature style instead of just being like more DC Universe shows, right? I mean, I guess maybe the hard R rating is what it is. But I mean, look how much you get for your fee. I think that's not bad. I mean, it's auto-renew, I found out when I got my confirmation. And it's not only auto-renew, like maybe like for like an extra month, you know, they'll auto-renew you for an entire year. So make sure you keep an eye on when you subscribe to DC Universe so you can cancel if necessary. But what do you think? Again, as a comic book fan, this is the life we lead. There's enough here that I'm like, okay, I'll check out. I mean, I'm going to review it. But even if I wasn't reviewing it, I'd be like, okay, at least I'll check out the first episode, right? But I just, it's frustrating to me, as is so often the case with DC properties. I think they're turning a corner, but, you know, I think it's interesting that this is where Geoff Johns went after being kicked out of the movie division, and it has the same problems that the movies had for so long. And that's that it's unnecessarily bad. You know, like anyone could come in here with a red pen and be like, in 5 minutes, substantially improve it. But I'm curious, for those of you who do like it, what do you like about it? Share your thoughts down below. And of course, as always, you can check out some more episodes right now.